Welcome children, take out your geography book. Pollution, types and sources, introduction. Environmental damage caused by improper management of resources or by careless human activities results in pollution of atmosphere. Now, environmental damages, what it cause? It cause, how it cause? It cause by carelessness of the human beings or the improper management of any resources. Hence, any activity that violates the original character of the natural and leads to its degradation is called pollution. And so, activities which violates the original characters of the nature and then it degrades the atmosphere, that is only called the pollution. A substance that causes pollution is called pollutant. Now, what is pollutant? Means the substance which causes pollution, it is only called the pollutant. For example, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide. Carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide, these are very harmful gases. When it gets mixed into the atmosphere, it causes pollutant. Pollutants may be biodegradable like domestic garbage or non-domestic, non-biodegradable like glass, plastic, etc. Now, pollutants, it may be biodegradable. Biodegradable, that we easily get from our home, that is the domestic garbage which we can easily get it from our home. And another is non-biodegradable, that is which doesn't mixes with the soil, that is glass, plastic, etc. The earth and its environment are facing a serious threat by increasing the pollution in air, water and soil. Now, earth and its environment, what it is facing? It is facing a very serious threat to the pollution, that is in the air, water and land. That is, land means soil. Now, these three components, these are very important. The life support system of the earth, land, water and soil, these are the vital life support system of the earth. The harmful effects of pollution on our biosphere are such that unless checked immediately, the planet will become inhabitable for all human, animals and marine life. Now, this harmful effect should be checked immediately. Otherwise, the planet, it will become inhabitable for all the creatures, that is the human beings, animals and marine life. Types and sources of pollution. We need to understand the sources of this pollutant and find ways to control pollution. Now, it is very necessary that sources of the pollutant should be understood, and we should find some way how to control this pollution. This also can be done by making people aware of its effect. Now, we can do this by making the people aware of its effect. With the increasing urbanization and industrialization, we are constantly exposed to radiation and noise pollution. Now, day by day, urbanization is increasing, industries are increasing, and so we are also constantly exposed to radiation and noise pollution, which are hazardous to our health and the airway. Noise pollution, it is very difficult. It is very polluted to our health and even the air we breathe. Environmental pollution is one of the major concerning facing the human race and other forms of life today. Now, environmental pollution, what is it? It is the major concern which faces the human race and other forms of life today. It is believed that the increasing pollution in the atmosphere has changed the climate around us. Now, what it is believed? That with the increasing pollution in the atmosphere, it has even changed the climate around the world. The major sources of pollutants have affected the natural sources that are interrelated. Now, major sources of pollution, what it has done? It has affected the natural resources and they are interrelated to each other, thus causing a combined threat to every existence of life on earth. And thus, what it causes? It causes a combined threat to every existence of life on earth. The progress in the field of electronics and computer is showing adverse effect in the form of e-waste. Now, progress of this field, progress in the field of electronics and computer, what it shows? It causes a great effect in the form of the electronic waste. The main type of environmental pollution are, now what are the main type of environmental pollution? That is air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, radiation pollution, noise pollution. First comes the air pollution. Air with 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen and 1% of all other gases supports life on Earth. Now, our atmosphere, what does it consist of? It consists of 7% of nitrogen, 21% of oxygen and 1% of all other gases. And these gases are important for our life on Earth. Various processes take place to sustain the regular percentage of gases and its composition. Now, various processes are needed. They take place to sustain this regular percentage of gases and its composition in them. Although atmospheric pollution can have natural sources, for example, volcanic eruption, the term is usually used to refer the gaseous byproducts of man processes such as energy production, waste incineration, transport, deforestation and agriculture. Although atmospheric pollution, what they have natural sources, for example, volcanic eruption, that is the term. This term is usually used to refer the gaseous byproduct of man-made process, so that is energy production, waste incineration, transport, deforestation and agriculture. Although air is still made up of mostly oxygen and nitrogen. Now, air, what is the air made up of? Air is mostly, it is made up of oxygen and nitrogen. Mankind, through pollution, has increased the levels of many stresses of many stresses. Now, though air is still, what is air made up of? It is made up of mostly oxygen and nitrogen. Mankind, through the pollution, these have increased the levels of the many stresses of gases. And in some cases, released completely new gases to that. Some cases we can see that there are new gases which are mixed in the atmosphere. Air pollution can result in poor air quality, both in cities and the countryside. Air pollution, what it causes, how it affects us? It can cause poor air quality in cities or in the countryside. Some air pollution makes people sick, causing breathing problems and increasing the likelihood of cancer. Now, some pollution, it makes the people ill, it causes breathing problem, it increases cancer. Others are harmful to plants, animals and ecosystem in which we live. Other pollution, it is very much harmful to nature, that is, it is harmful to plants, animals and even the ecosystem in which we all live. Some air pollutants return to earth in the form of acid rain. Now, some pollution, it returns back to the earth in the form of acid rain, which corrodes statues and buildings. Is what it does? It damages the statues and buildings, damages the crops and forest, and then makes the lakes and streams very unsuitable for fish and other plants and even the animal. And with this, I'm ending my today's class. Goodbye.